Hello everyone, welcome back to Biophilia, your all-time study mate. Today we are going to continue with the fifth part about this chapter, that is pancreas. If you like this video and get some help, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our amazing channel Biophilia. So after the journey of undergoing the understanding about many glands of the endocrine system, तो हमने कौन कौन से glands cover किए हैं? We have already covered about hypothalamus, pituitary gland, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, adrenal gland, and now we are here with the sixth gland, that is pancreas. So pancreas जो है, it is a bit different than the other glands because it is called as a composite or heterocrine gland. So what is the meaning of hetero? Hetero is going to mean that there are two different substances present in it. So heterocrine glands jo hote hain, these are going to have both the exocrine secretion as well as the endocrine secretion. So exocrine secretion jo exocrine hota hai, that means the secretion are going to come from the duct, whereas endocrine are being the ductless secretion, unke paas duct nahi hoga. So jo exocrine secretions hote hain, the exocrine is going to be the enzymes. So jo digestive enzymes hai, the digestive juices jo hai, that comes from the pancreas is going to come from the exocrine system. But the endocrine part of the pancreas is going to supply the hormones that we are going to see in a much more while. So here in our study about endocrine gland, so hum pancreas ka sirf endocrine function yahan pe function dekhenge. The exocrine function we have already seen in the chapter of digestive system. So endocrine ko hum detail mein samjhenge, and here the hormones of pancreas will be discussed. So pancreas is going to be a organ which has a origin from the endoderm of the embryo, and inside the pancreas there are going to be many more cells, and these cells are not less, but these are over 1 million of the cells which will be located around the blood capillaries, and these cells are nothing but the islets of Langerhans. Now these islets of Langerhans are going to be a part of which it is a part of endocrine part of the pancreas. So जो islets of Langerhans है वो endocrine cells के हैं, और जो pancreatic acini होते हैं, these will be the part of exocrine system. So here in the photograph also you can understand that the yellow colored parts that you can see are going to be the pancreatic acini, which are going to be the exocrine areas, whereas your islets of Langerhans will be the part of your endocrine system that we are going to understand in detail. So islets of Langerhans jo hote hain, these are going to constitute about only 1-2% of the pancreatic tissue. Rest of that will be covered by the acini and other substances in the pancreas. So even if the amount of pancreatic tissue that is belonging to the endocrine system is less, but still it is going to be very important. And this importance will be understood once we understand the type of cells. So type of cells, there are two types. One will be called as alpha cells, one will be called as beta cells. Those cells alag alag hai, and these two both will secrete two different kinds of endocrine secretions. And endocrine secretions kya hote hai? These are nothing but the hormones. So now let us understand in detail about these cells, that is alpha and beta cells. So we see the first type of cells under the endocrine part of the pancreas, that is alpha cells, or you also call them as A cells. So these A cells or alpha cells are going to secrete a hormone that is called as glucagon. This glucagon is a peptide hormone, and this peptide means it is a chain of amino acids. So amino acid chain is the base of formation of glucagon. So this glucagon, when it is released in the body, it is going to have some physiological changes, and these changes are going to be the functions of the glucagon. So glucagon majorly kab release hota hai? It is released to have the maintenance of normal blood glucose level. जब ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल ज़्यादा हो या कम हो, उसमें बॉडी को तकलीफ होगी, एंड दैट शुड नॉट हैपन. एंड फॉर दैट रीज़न टू हॉर्मोन्स विल बी रिलीज फ्रॉम द पैनक्रियाज, विच विल बी हेल्पिंग इन मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल. सो एक रिलीज होगा अल्फा सेल्स से, एक रिलीज होगा बीटा सेल्स से. सो अल्फा सेल्स से जो ग्लूकागॉन रिलीज होता है, इट इज़ गोइंग टू हेल्प इन मेंटेनेंस बाय एक्टिंग ऑन द लिवर सेल्स. एंड व्हाट आर लिवर सेल्स कॉल्ड? लिवर सेल्स आर कॉल्ड एज हिपैटोसाइट्स. नाउ दीज हिपैटोसाइट्स व्हेन रिसीव द सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम ग्लूकागॉन, दे आर गोइंग टू हेल्प इन कन्वर्जन ऑफ स्टोर्ड ग्लाइकोजन. और स्टोर्ड ग्लाइकोजन कहाँ है? इट इज़ इन द लिवर. सो द स्टोर्ड glycogen is going to be converted into glucose and the process and this glycogen बहुत सारे glucose से बना हुआ था. ये storage form, compact storage form था. अब ये storage form को तोड़ मरोड़ के single single units में free form में कर दिया. That is nothing but the process called as glycogenolysis. That means there is going to be breaking down or breakdown of glycogen, and this process is going to be stimulated because of release of glucagon. So once there is a lot amount of glucose released in the bloodstream, the amount of blood glucose level in the blood can be maintained. So now after this, the glucagon is going to function for the process of gluconeogenesis. Gluconeogenesis ko again, if you try to break the words, one is the word that is glucose, then one is the word that is new, and genesis is the meaning for formation. So there is going to be formation of glucose from new sources. Aur ye new sources kahan se aayenge? New sources can be either amino acids, they can be proteins, or they can be you can say fats. All these are the new sources which are not directly giving out glucose, but they will be used to have glucose formation. So in a way, after reading all these things, what can you understand? For the maintenance of normal glucose level in the blood, glucagon is going to increase glucose level. What is it going to do? It is increasing glucose levels in the blood level. So blood glucose level increase kaun karega? Glucagon karega, which is released from the alpha cells. And because it is increasing the blood levels of glucose, it is going to be called as hyperglycemic hormone. Hyper, that is increased, glycemic is related to glucose. So when glucose is increased by the hormone is called as hyperglycemic hormone. So when is it released? Jab blood glucose level kam ho jayega, at that time there is going to be release of decreased glucose in blood. Aur jaise hi ye signals notice kar liye jayenge by the receptors, what will happen? There will be release of glucagon. And this condition, when it will be occurring? It can be occurring when the person is exercising. So exercise hai tab bahut zyada glucose use ho raha hai, then that there is a condition of decreased blood glucose level. So decreased blood glucose hone pe pancreatic alpha cells will start to release glucagon. Glucagon jaise hi release hoga, liver mein glycogen ko glucose mein break kiya jayega, and once the glucose has been entered into the blood stream, there will be increase in blood sugar level, and that will help to maintain. But uske opposite condition bhi ho sakti hai. If the person is eating a lot, then also blood sugar level is going to increase. And then instead of alpha cells, the beta cells are going to get stimulated to release our second hormone from the pancreas, that is insulin. So now let us understand the opposite condition of this. That is, जब blood sugar level increase हो जाता है, उसको maintain करने के लिए क्या किया जाता है? So once the blood glucose levels are going to increase in the bloodstream, this is going to be stimulation of our second cell, that is called as beta cells. So beta cells bolo ya you call them as B cells, they both are the same thing. So B cells or beta cells, one and the same, and these are going to stimulate the hormone that is insulin. Again, insulin is a peptide hormone, and the functions of insulin are going to be for bringing the blood glucose level down. Okay, so first of all, I will tell you कि यहाँ पे insulin का function, majorly function क्या होगा? Major function is going to be decrease
ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल. सो जो ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल बढ़ाएगा दैट इज गोइंग टू बी ग्लूकागॉन. ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल कम करेगा दैट इज गोइंग टू बी इंसुलिन. सो ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल कम करने के लिए क्या क्या स्टेप्स लिए जाएंगे. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देर इज गोइंग टू बी इंक्रीज अपटेक ऑफ ग्लूकोज बाय द सेल्स सो दैट देर कैन बी रेस्पिरेशन एंड ग्लूकोज कैन बी यूज. सो देर विल बी यूज ऑफ ग्लूकोज बाय सेल्स. सिंपल things you can understand. There will be use of glucose by the cells and use कहाँ से होगा. It will be used in the help of respiration. फिर there will be increase uptake of glucose by liver and liver में कौन majorly work करेगा. The hepatocytes will be helping to convert the loose glucose into formation of ग्लाइकोजन. ग्लाइकोजन फॉर्म होगा उसको स्टोर कर लिया जाएगा एंड दिस कैन बी डन बाय द लिवर. इट कैन बी डन बाय मसल सेल्स एंड देयर द ग्लाइकोजन कैन बी मेड एंड द मेकिंग ऑफ ग्लाइकोजन और मेकिंग द स्टोर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ ग्लूकोज विल बी द प्रोसेस दैट इज ग्लाइकोजेनेसिस. सो द अपोजिट रिएक्शन विल हैपन. प्रीवियसली वी सॉ दैट वॉज ग्लाइकोलाइसिस. Here there will be glycogenesis, whereas glycogen is formed. ताकि जो ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल फ्री घूम रहा है उसको स्टोर कर लिया जाए एंड द ब्लड लेवल कैन बी डिक्रीज. देन देर कैन बी इंक्रीज ऑफ अपटेक ऑफ अमीनो एसिड्स बाई द सेल्स एंड सिंथेसिस ऑफ प्रोटीन्स विल ऑकर. सो अगर प्रोटीन्स और अमीनो एसिड्स सेल्स ने यूज कर लिए वॉट विल हैपन. There is no free amino acid or protein, then there will be no gluconeogenesis. और gluconeogenesis नहीं होगा then new glucose will not be formed. So in a way that will also help to decrease the blood glucose level. And the fourth thing that can be done is there can be increase in fat synthesis. So fat synthesis बढ़ाने से भी the ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल कैन बी डिक्रीज्ड. सो फाइनली वंस वी अंडरस्टूड कि ये सारे जो भी फंक्शंस हो रहे हैं इट हैज़ अ मेजर रोल दैट इज टू डिक्रीज द ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल एंड सिंस द हॉर्मोन वर्क्स फॉर डिक्रीजिंग द ग्लूकोज लेवल्स इट इज कॉल्ड एज हाइपो दैट इज लेस एंड ग्लाइसिमिक इज रिलेटेड टू ग्लूकोज. सो ग्लूकोज लेवल को कम करने के लिए जो हॉर्मोन काम करेगा दैट इज इंसुलिन विच इज अ हाइपोग्लाइसिमिक हॉर्मोन. सो इन दिस हाउ द इंसुलिन इज गोइंग टू वर्क. इंसुलिन इज गोइंग टू गो ऑन टू द इंसुलिन रिसेप्टर. इंसुलिन रिसेप्टर पर जैसे ही ये बैठ जाएगा तब क्या होगा. जो ग्लूकोज चैनल क्लोज्ड था पहले जहाँ पे ग्लूकोज जा नहीं पाता था. ग्लूकोज कुड नॉट एंटर. देर वॉज नो गेट ओपन. ग्लूकोज अंदर नहीं जा पाता था. अब जैसे ही इंसुलिन रिसेप्टर के ऊपर इंसुलिन बैठ जाएगा एंड इट विल अनलॉक द ग्लूकोज चैनल. वो स्विच ऑन हो जाएगी एंड द चैनल विल बी ओपन फॉर द ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल्स टू एंटर इन टू द सेल. एंड वंस दे एंटर इन टू द सेल दे कैन बी यूज फॉर वेरियस पर्पजेज दैट इज फॉर रेस्पिरेशन और द प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ग्लाइकोजन. ऑल दैट प्रोसेसेस कैन हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ insulin has opened the glucose gates. So that was about the beta cells. Now agar कोई purposes में अगर insulin का production कम हो जाता है if there is hyposecretion that is less secretion of insulin what is going to be the condition. Less secretion of insulin है. insulin का normal function क्या है. insulin is going to be the hormone that is going to decrease blood glucose level. So अगर blood glucose level decrease नहीं हो रहे हैं because decreased amount of insulin what will happen. The condition will be excess glucose in the blood because hormone nahi hai and because of that the blood glucose cannot enter into the cells and in such condition wherein the blood has excess glucose the condition is called as hyperglycemia. Hyper is more, glycemia is glucose. So much more amount of glucose will be found in the blood and if this condition of lot of glucose in the blood is prolonged, if it is for the long time, then it can lead to a complex disease called as diabetes mellitus. So diabetes mellitus, mellitus jo word hota होता है, इट इज़ रिलेटेड टू हनी. एंड हाउ इज हनी? हनी इज स्वीट. सो स्वीटनेस दैट इज रिलेटेड टू ग्लूकोज. सो यू कैन रिलेट इट दैट डायबिटीज मेलाइटिस इज गोइंग टू बी अ डिसऑर्डर दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द ग्लूकोज लेवल्स इन द ब्लड. वेर एज प्रीवियसली वी हैड ऑल्सो सीन अबाउट अ डिसीज दैट इज डायबिटीज इनसिपिडस. सो अगर किसी को याद होगा, वी हैड सीन अबाउट द डिसीज दैट इज डायबिटीज इनसिपिडस. इन दिस डिसीज देर वॉज नो रिलेशन ऑफ ग्लूकोज. ओके, देर वॉज नो रोल ऑफ ग्लूकोज इन हेयर. वॉट वॉज द रोल ऑफ डायबिटीज इनसिपिडस? यू कैन गो एंड चेक आर प्रीवियस वीडियो अबाउट एड्रीनल ग्लैंड एंड देर यू कैन फाइंड एवरीथिंग अबाउट द डिसीज ऑफ डायबिटीज इनसिपिडस. सो डायबिटीज मेलाइटस जो अभी हमारे कंसर्न में है, दैट इज अबाउट द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ इंसुलिन. सो डायबिटीज इंसिपिटस हैज सिम्टम्स ऑफ द लॉस ऑफ एक्सेसिव ग्लूकोज थ्रू यूरिन. सो यूरिन में ग्लूकोज मिल सकता है एंड इफ द ग्लूकोज इज गोइंग थ्रू द यूरिन देर कैन बी फॉर्मेशन ऑफ हार्मफुल कंपाउंड दैट आर कॉल्ड एज कीटोन बॉडीज. सो अलॉन्ग विद ग्लूकोज कीटोन बॉडीज कैन ऑल्सो बी सीन इन द urine, that is through excretion of these out of the body, so that it can help to reduce the levels of glucose in a way. So as the glucose is excreted through urine, glucose जैसे ही urine में filter out होने के लिए जाता है, उसके साथ water is also attracted. So for example, if this was your collecting tubule, okay, this is your collecting tubule, और यहाँ से your recta is going, and what is happening from here, there is going to be glucose. So ye glucose jaise hi jata hai, because of higher concentration and lower concentration, as glucose is going into the urine formation, the water is also attracted. Jo water molecules hai, water molecules will also enter into the concentrate of the urine formation, and because of that, as glucose is going to enter more and more, jitna jyada glucose jayega to get out of the urine, more and more amount of water is going to enter, and because of that, there is going to be excessive urination. Bahut baar urination hoga, and since the water is getting out of the body, there is going to be dehydration in the tissues because there will be no water left in the body to use it for other purposes. So because of excessive urination, dehydration, the person will undergo excessive thirst, and this excessive thirst condition is called as polydipsia. So polydipsia, excessive thirst, kis wajah se hai? Because of excessive glucose, and since glucose is more, it is excreted out in the urine, and because of water is attracted towards glucose, water will also go out and get excreted out of it, and that will cause the excessive urination and dehydration leading to polydipsia. So with this you can understand that some people, old age people, you might have heard about, they take insulin shots. So insulin shots या insulin guns जो होते हैं, these are going to be the artificial hormone, and these artificial hormone of insulin will be provided so that the person can maintain his or her glucose levels, and that will help to cover out the diabetes mellitus conditions. So blood glucose level कितना होना चाहिए, what is the normal range and everything has been located over here. You can understand the normal conditions. अगर normal के blood glucose level कम है, तो कम होने पे क्या हो जाएगा, it will be called as hypoglycemia. Whereas if the blood glucose levels are more, it is hyperglycemia, that can lead to diabetes mellitus. So these results can be calculated with a blood glucose measuring device. And on that device, if there's some person who has diabetes, they have been checking their glucose levels, and you can go and find out the levels of what they have as their readings, and that will help you to understand about the diabetes in much more easier way. So there are going to be two types of diabetes mellitus. So it is not necessary ki hamesha insulin kam hone ki wajah se hi diabetes hoga. There are going to be two types, that is type 1 and type 2. टाइप वन जो होता है इट इज़ गोइंग टू बी अ डायबिटीज विच इज़ इंसुलिन डिपेंडेंट डायबिटीज, यानी वो इंसुलिन के ऊपर डिपेंड करेगा कितना इंसुलिन आ रहा है, दैट इज़ गोइंग टू डिपेंड दैट व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल द पर्सन हैज़। सो इट इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज जुवेनाइल ऑनसेट डायबिटीज बिकॉज इट इज़ गोइंग टू ऑकर मेजरली इन यंगर पीपल, दैट इज अबाउट लेस देन 20 ईयर्स ऑफ एज, and it is going to be caused because of autoimmune disorder, yani aapke body ki immunity hi the cells of beta cells, the beta cells ko destroy karegi, khud ke immunity cells, khud ke antibodies beta cells ko destroy karenge, and because of that the pancreas will not be able to produce the amount of insulin required, and because of failure of production of insulin blood glucose level will not be able to decrease or it will not be able to maintain in the body. Second type of diabetes hota hai, it is going to be a type 2 diabetes which is called as non-insulin dependent. Why? Because it doesn't matter how much insulin is produced or it is not produced, it doesn't matter, because it is going to be the case wherein there is cells or the target cells which become less sensitive to insulin. Unke jo insulin receptors hote hai, wo insulin receptors इंसुलिन को पहचान ही नहीं पाते हैं, वो बोलते हैं वी डोंट नो इंसुलिन, हु आर यू, वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू अलाउ यू, एंड सिंस इट कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दैट इंसुलिन हैज़ बीन कमिंग, इट कैन नॉट रिकग्नाइज, दे कैन नॉट रिस्पॉन्ड टू इंसुलिन, उसकी वजह से जो इन ग्लूकोज के चैनल्स हैं जो दैट वी हैव सीन दैट हाउ इंसुलिन वर्क्स, सो इन दैट अंटिल एंड अनलेस इंसुलिन मॉलिक्यूल दैट इज डज नॉट कम एंड सिट ऑन टू द रिसेप्टर टू ओपन द गेट्स ऑफ ग्लूकोज चैनल्स, द ग्लूकोज विल नॉट बी एंटरिंग इन टू द सेल्स। सो यहाँ पे प्रॉब्लम क्या है, यहाँ पे जो रखवाली है, जो वॉचमैन है, वो वॉचमैन बोलता है हम ये लोगों को जानते नहीं है, हम गेट नहीं खोलेंगे, जबकि आपके सारे बहुत सारे लोग आके खड़े हैं, इंसुलिन इज ऑलरेडी देयर इन द ब्लड लेवल बट स्टिल द ग्लूकोज इज हाई, इवन द इंसुलिन लेवल्स आर हाई बट स्टिल द the functioning is not occurred, in that case it will be called as a diabetes mellitus type 2, which is generally occurring on the maturity onset and it occurs later in the life, yani wo young logon mein nahi hoga. So these are the two types of diabetes. One is insulin dependent, jahan pe pancreas insulin hormone bana nahi pata hai, but there the receptors are functional, there the receptors can work, but the इंसुलिन इज नॉट प्रोड्यूस, रिसेप्टर वहाँ पे काम करे या ना करे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है, बट हियर द इंसुलिन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द पैनक्रियास, इनफैक्ट द बीटा सेल्स, बट स्टिल इट इज नॉट फंक्शनिंग बिकॉज द रिसेप्टर्स और द सेल्स कैन नॉट रिस्पॉन्ड प्रॉपरली, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट द ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल्स आर नॉट मेंटेन्ड. सो दीज वर द टू टाइप्स ऑफ कंडीशंस दैट कैन ऑकर बिकॉज ऑफ इंसुलिन not functioning properly or not released. So with this we come to the end of the functioning about pancreas. So we had seen about two hormones, that is glucagon and insulin. So if you like this video, if you got some help to understand about pancreas in much more better way, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our amazing channel. We will continue this chapter with next gland in the next video. Till then, bye bye everyone, thank you.